In the previous lecture, we have covered electric displacement, and this topic is of more importance, and conceptually we will have to differentiate between the electric field which we are studying for the last few chapters, and then this new concept which is of the electric displacement. This came when we started discussion on electric field and matter. So we will have to clarify few things regarding the two. So I decided to record another lecture on this one. In the previous lecture, I have discussed some aspects of the electric displacement and the electric field, but I think it is necessary to further clarify this concept more. So the very first thing is that what about this thing from the point of view of history? So the historical point of view means the very first one is the historical point of view. Basically, this is a misnomer, means it's a wrong name to something. Although it was coined by Maxwell, but it's a wrong name given to something. And today we know that it has nothing to do with the displacement of charges. Means electric displacement has nothing to do with this. So it was a wrong name put for this thing. It is basically a mathematical tool, or we have generated a convenience for calculation in order to deal only free charges inside a material, while electric field deals both the charges, whether they are free or they are bound. So we will have to clarify this thing, that when we know this thing, electric displacement, so it is a misnomer, a wrong name was given to something, or a misunderstanding of the actual phenomenon which is occurring here. So displacement, it has nothing to do anything with the charge displacement. And this is basically a concept which the concept which basically means D, which relates the electric field and polarization together. And we have this thing. So what is basically the parallel between, means we will discuss the parallel between the electric field and the electric displacement, and then the deception, that why deception occurs here, or what kind of deception we shouldn't go in for that one, which will basically confuse our understanding of electric displacement in electric field. Now, historically, we have cleared that thing, that it's a misnomer, it's a wrong name given to something which is occurring inside a material. It has nothing to do with the charges displacement. The next thing is that we have another point that we have is the similarities between the two. The similarities. Now, if I look at the parallel between the two is that Gauss's law gives divergence of electric field equal to rho over epsilon naught. Now, this rho is basically the total charge, which is the free plus the bound charge. So here in Gauss's law, when we consider the divergence of electric field, we are considering the total charge. And when we consider the divergence of the electric displacement D, then this is rho free, means it only counts for the free charges and doesn't count for the bound charge. So this is one of the parallel that we draw between the two. Like, we call this the Gauss's law for electric field and the Gauss's law for the electric displacement. Now, what is the deception here? Like, we will have to draw the deceptive parallel. So the deception is basically here that this seems like the D, this seems like D is a rescaled version of E, which is not the situation. Like, D is not a rescaled version of E. So we will have to conceptually clear this thing, that it is not a rescaled version of this. And why not this thing? We can consider an example. If I consider the example of a dielectric material, then in this dielectric material, I know that E accounts for the bound charge. I know that inside a dielectric material, rho B is basically minus divergence of P. That we say that E accounts for the polarization charges, while what D does basically here inside a material, D basically hides these bound charges, and it D equal epsilon naught E plus P. It basically combine these two in order to give its value. Like, it hides the bound charges and only account for free charges here. So we have a deceptive parallel here that we will have to take in count here. Now, another thing in this discussion, we have the third, like, for example, the linearity between the two. Linearity in materials. As we know that in linear and isotropic material, we have D equal epsilon E, where epsilon is basically epsilon naught epsilon R, the permittivity of free space and the relative permittivity of the material. And this shows, like, means a parallel that D is basically proportional to E. But this thing is not a universal truth. This is not universally acceptable, because this is only true for linear, when the material is linear, like when the polarization is proportional to just electric field, like the same power of both, linearity between them. Like, we write P equal epsilon naught chi E and E, which we will discuss in the next section. But here, such a material we will call a linear material, that the electric field strength is such that the polarization is directly proportional to each other. Non-linear, when this E will have some other powers like 2, 3 and so. 2 will be second order non-linear, 3 will be third order non-linear and so on. And if we consider other materials, for example, means material are linear. The other thing is that the materials are basically homogeneous. Like they are not heterogeneous, homogeneous. They are homogeneous material. And also they are isotropic material. Isotropic. Like in all direction the material is the same. So we have the expression D equal epsilon E valid in when a material will be linear, homogeneous and isotropic. Now what will happen means a deceptive parallel is basically this thing that we will not have to confuse this with non-linear material. Non-linear material. So we have to differentiate this with the non-linear material. Non-linear. In which P is not directly proportional to E. Non-linear, for example, if we are having a ferroelectric material, then this D will not be equal to epsilon E. And anisotropic material, for example, anisotropic. Anisotropic, for example, if we are having a crystal is an isotropic material. So in that situation, D and E are basically not exactly proportional. Rather, we will have to replace this D equal epsilon E. It will be replaced by D. It will be replaced by D and then I and then epsilon I and J, and electric field is J. So it will be replaced by a tensor because different direction will have different response because it is not isotropic, it is anisotropic. So different direction will have different response, and that we will say that tensors will take place here, and the material is means the D equal epsilon E is not valid here. So the parallel that we draw in case of materials, then it is not a universal truth. It is basically a special case when we have D equal epsilon E. We can consider another aspect that we can study is the physical and mathematical role of D and E. Mathematical role that what are the things between D and E? So let's say if I consider the parallel between the two, then energy stored inside an electric field. So the energy density in case of electric field is half epsilon naught E squared. This I know from my previous chapter, the second chapter. And if I consider the energy density in for electric displacement, then this is half D dot E. So what does this mean? This means the this is the parallel between the two, that we are having energy density for electric field and for this one. So basically the energy density, our energy is not stored directly in D, is it is stored directly in E. So the deceptive parallel between E and D I can draw here. that E has a direct physical sense.